Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channels. In this video, we are going to learn about how to create a registration form using the Spring Boot with MySQL. You can use any database like MongoDB, you can use Oracle, it's fine. But I'm going to prefer MySQL because MySQL is right now available in my system. So I'm going to do with this. Apart from this, for user registration forms, I am going to use for Spring Boot, MySQL Workbench I am using, and Spring Data JPA to communicate with the database, like our project is communicate with the database. Third is ThemeLib. ThemeLib is used to create a dynamic HTML page, so I am going to use a ThemeLib. For Lambak, you already know about how to create a setter getter, all argument constructors, no arg constructors. So for this, I'm going to use Lambak. I'm going to prepare with STS-CD, okay? And bootstrap concept I'm going to use in this video. So I hope you understood like what I'm going to do in this video. Okay, it's clear. So let's start now to develop registration form. So please open you're also STS. If you have STS or Eclipse, it's fine. No problems, no doubt in that. Second is I will show you like how our project is look like. So I'm going to develop like this one registration form, user registration form. Here I take name, username, email, phone number, password, confirm password or gender. And once you click the registration forms, this data will be going to the server. One controller is accept, receive this all data and put this data in database. So these things I'm going to cover. This is the user registration form. So you can do it. So let's start now. If your registration is successful, it's so. Congratulations, registration successfully. If registration is failed, then saying sorry, please enter correct user ID and password. Okay guys, I hope you understood. Thank you. Next, what you have to do? Okay, so let us create the applications and do work on that. Okay, so I'm going to create one Spring Boot application. So first open your Eclipse or STS, go to the file, new, and create a Spring starter project. Here you can give in your name of the project. What is the name? You can use like a Spring Boot registration form, user registration form, Maven jar java 11 com.app, everything is fine. Registration app, you can write registration app. Registration name, and finally you can click on next. Now you have to decide whatever you are going to use. Based on that, you have to add the dependency on your project. Okay, so I already told you in previously in first time ki I will use Lambak JPA. If I want to use Oracle database, definitely I have to use MySQL driver, a Spring Web because this is the Spring Boot application, a Spring Dev Tools, Automatics Run, ThemeLib I'm going to use. Okay, so these things I am going to use. You can search here also. If you not find here, you can search and you can get it. Okay, fine. Click on next and finish it. It takes some time to create your application based on your internet connections. So you can see here our application is created. A Spring Boot registration form. I hope you understood. Now what I have to do? First I will check whatever application I have created, it's running or not. Okay, so for this you have to write something in main methods. So what are the main methods? If you open your structures, you can see one main method is there. It's automatically created by the Spring Boot applications. Okay, fine. So S out. S out application. just write anything so that you can, whenever you compile, run it, so you can see, okay, our application is running on. Okay, so for this I have written one printout method, so you can see the console also. Okay, fine. So first I have to do to configure our database with our project. So in a Spring Boot, it's a very easy task to configure, to connect any database with our project. Really, believe me, it's a very simple. If you go in Spring, if you go with any JDBC technique, if you go with, you can say, Spring Data JDBC, a simple JDBC, yeah, any other kinds of the application, web application, then it's a very difficult to configure any database. But this is the very simple in a Spring Boot. How can you do it? You just go to your SRC main resources. Open the application.properties file. Here you can change your port number, server.port. By default it's running on 8080, but I want to change it. So you can change it, server.port equal to 8081. Okay. Now, for connection of your MySQL database, you can open your MySQL workbench. I have a MySQL workbench. So I will open my MySQL workbench. Okay. And three things I have to provide in application.properties file. And then after, my application is connected with MySQL server. How? You see, here is the root of the user. Username is root and password is also root. You can see the port number, localhost 33306. This is the port numbers and URL you have to know. So root. Once you enter, you can enter in your MySQL server. Yeah, you can say MySQL workbench. Here I have already created one PrinceDB. So no need to create one more database, because in this database you can store, okay, your users. So for examples, if already available, yeah, already it's happened. So right now you can see two users tables is available. So one is users, one is users. Okay, you don't want to worry about it, it's fine. You just have to check PrinceDB is available or not. Okay, yeah, it's available. If you want, you can create also other also, but it's fine. I am agree with this. Now you have to give the three things. One is URL, second is user ID, username you can say, or password, and one hibernate annotation. Hibernate annotation to generate automatically your query and save the data and perform all the operations, like given the grant, so that you can perform all the operations. So these things you have to mention it. Okay, so for URL you can write Spring dot, you are going to configure your project with MySQL. If you are configured with some other database, then you have to give in the URL based on that. Okay, it's a Oracle if you use, it's a different PostgreSQL, it's a different. You just want to change your URL, nothing else. So Spring dot data source dot URL. URL is nothing but it's very simple. You can give JDBC colon MySQL. You can search on net, you can get it. Here you can write localhost LOCAL local host port number. Port number is 3306 and last you have to give your database name DB. So I already created the database name. You can also create like that. Okay. So it's created. Now you have to give what? Username. So username is what? You can put here dot username. Username is nothing but you can give your username database and password. So just go this and password is also root. And one more query you have to give. Okay, I will collect it in one place. Okay, and you have to give the Hibernate query. So Hibernate query is automatically create the table. You don't need to create the table first. But if you not given here those Hibernate query, then manually you have to create the table also. So I don't want to do like that. Okay, so you can write like spring dot JPA. It's a JPA query dot Hibernate DDL auto update. That's it. Your database is connected now with your application. Your database is connected with your applications. If you want to use your Oracle database, just change the URL and create one. You don't want to create any database also. You don't want to provide any database name also. It's automatically create tables based on the user ID and password in your Oracle database. Okay, I will configure those things also. I have already made so many video on that, so you can go through this. Okay, fine. So right now my this application is connected with our application. If you want to check, you just run this application, run as Spring Boot app. Okay, so first work I have done is I have created the connections between our application. If you open these things, you can see here Hikari JPA helper package connections, everything is happened. Connection is created, Tomcat servers, you can see it. Completed Hibernate dialog. You can see this Hibernate dialog also. Okay, so everything is happened. It means our application is connected with database. First things. Now, what is the second things? Second things is, oh my god, why it's not happened? Okay. Fine. Second thing is, if our application is connected, you can see here output also. Okay, now what you have to do? So okay, close it, it's not required. Now I'm going to create the package, some package. Package in the sense, I want controller package. So I will search package. Package in the sense dot controller. Controller is created. I want one more package, and those package name is entity dot entity entity. I want one more package repo. Okay, package repo dot repo. I want one more package service. If you want, otherwise it's easy, you don't want to create it, everything you can handle inside the controllers. Okay, but if I create it, it's little bit lengthy. You have to call same method in this place, then this place, but it is the standard. So just create it, no problem. So dot service, because controller is directly not communicate with our database, so better to go through this. Okay, it's also fine. Okay, Now what I have to do? I have to create one entity. Entity name is what? What I have to take data? Those things. So create one entity class. Entity class is nothing but user class. So create one user class. And if you create the user class, you can use here lambac. How? At the rate data. So getter setter is created. I hope you understood. At the rate data, getter setter is created. So first define whatever property in your database. Private string name. I have to take name. Private string user ID. User ID. Yeah, username. You can take username. Name, username, private string email, private string phone, private string phone. Then after password. Private string confirm password confirm confirm या C password लिख दो, it's also fine. C password and private string I want gender. That's it. This much data. So if for this I have to create getter setter, I have to create all the constructors, I have to create no argument constructor, two string equals hash code method. So better to go with lambac, just annotate with at the rate data, so automatically correct, it's created what getter setter for all the variables. Apart from this, it's created equals to a string, equals to a string hash code method also. All argument constructor, he created all the argument constructors. No argument constructor, it's created no argument constructors. Annotate this entity, it's become entity. Give the table name, so give the table name also. So I will give the table name is called user register. Register. I want this name of the tables. So give here name. Okay, fine. I want to make username as a ID. So at the rate ID, annotate this. So this is the primary key. Username is the primary key here. Our application is running on everything I have generated. Our entity class is done. Now what I have to do? Now you have to prepare your repo class. Okay, so this is the able to communicate with your applications. Okay, so I have created service also, so I have to use service also in this project. Okay, no problem, I will use. Okay, so create here one class, not class, this is the interface. But I will take user repo. Okay, and remove this, make it interface, and extend JP repository and pass here user class and ID as a string. Okay, control shift to import this package. Final, your repository is also done. Now what you have to do? Now you have to focus to service. Then after we go to the controllers. So in service, you are not going to write everything, okay? But for examples, if you want to create some methods, okay, I will create it, I will do it. So go to your first create one interface. So go to new, create one interface, and this is called user service, and this interface is created. Create one method inside this user interface, like this is able to store, this is able to store the data in database. This is able to store the data in database. So you can write like okay, public void register users. Okay, this is not going to return anything. Okay, it's simply saying register users. One more class you are going to create inside this service. So this is the class, okay, and class is user service impl. Create this and implements user service. That's it. If you implement, so user service having a one unimplemented method, so add it, and you have to write the logic here. So logic is nothing but you have to auto add user repo. So first annotate this @ repository. Okay, it's done, and go to the service. Here you have to create a private user repo and auto add it. Okay, now you have to save the data, but one more things I have missed. Whatever data you have to call register users, so you have to pass some data like user data, users. So you have to write this one, and again go to this place, you have to change in this also users. Okay, fine, users. Now so you have a already repo, so just here you can write repo dot save function is available in JP repository. So you can save function and just passed here user, so automatically user is gone in database. Okay, it's gone in database, and this user method you can call with controllers. So this is the service class, so annotate this as a service, annotate this service class. So automatically this bin is created for this. Okay, fine, I hope guys you understood. Okay, I hope you understood. Okay, fine. So this thing is done. Just close everything. And now you have to create a controllers. Our UI page is also not created right now. Okay, you have to create UI page also. So for this, I'm going to inside the controllers, and I will create one class, and this is called user controller. This is called user controller. Still my video is gone. Why it's happened like that today? Okay, so you can see here, this is the user controllers. So annotate it as a controller. So this is the controllers, and create one methods public string register is one of the methods, and here you can return return register page. This is a register page I have to create it, and here you can take @ get mapping and just anyone call with slash, you have to call these methods. So right now if you go to the browsers, if you hit it, maybe you got some problem. Okay, so I'm not going to do anything, so I just copy this, and I'm going to create one template for it, dynamic template. So go to your project. So this is my project, and in this project having a, you can see, template src main resources having a template. Go to the template, create one file with the name of register.html. be careful, okay, write this and write here, hi, I am Prince, and check it, it's working or not. Okay, so right now our application is running on, is running mode, and go to your browsers. Here you can search localhost. If you hit it, you can see here, I am Prince Kumar. So your application is given the output. Now I have to do some work. I have to create one login form. Not login form, register form. So like that, I have already registered form now. So for this, I have to do work on that. So this is the registration form I have. Registration forms. So like that, I have to create the forms. How can I create it? With the Bootstrap and ThemeLib, I'm going to create. So I'm going to use Bootstrap and ThemeLib. So go to your application and go to register.html file and remove it. Okay, save it. Now you, what you have to do, you have to go to the Bootstrap, go to your browsers, search Bootstrap. If you search Bootstrap, you go first website, get Bootstrap, get started. If you scroll it, go down, you can see a starter template. Here you can see copy it, come back in your project and paste it. Now you have to make it some formatted. So remove this one. Okay, now you have to remove these things. Okay, remove this thing also, and okay, and copy these things. Copy this, cut this, and go to here and paste inside the head, because this is the script I have to put inside the head. Okay, this one is also fine. You want to change any titles, you can change it. This is the register form. Guys, you have to do also like that. So if you follow me, you can understood very easily. So this is the registers. Here I am going to write what? First I am going to create one dev tag. Okay, here I am going to create. First of all, I am going to create one dev tag. I am going to now create one registration form. How can you create it? Okay, so let us see. I don't know too much how to create, but I know little bit. Okay, so div, and here you can maintain class equal to container, container, container. Okay, that's it, container is done. Now inside this, you have to print one h1. and inside the h1 you have to write user registration registrations form. Okay, simple registration forms. If you want to do some style, you can do it like style equal to color style equal to color, color equal to red. That's it. If you go to your browsers and if you hit it, you can see user registration form. Okay, you are able to see user registration form. Okay, like this. Okay, fine guys. Now you have to develop some input field. How you can do it? So for input field, you can do like, go to the Bootstrap. Here you can search input your control form. So you can see here, if you search form controls. So if you go to form controls, you can see here email address and like this. So I want this one only, I don't want text area. So I will copy this one first. Okay, I will copy this first and go to the our applications. Okay, go to the our application and inside this create one form tag. I have to create one form tag. It's a user registration form, so create one form tag. Okay, form tag is ready. Make this form tag as a class and call, not make. First I will show you like how it's look like. So this is the forms. Go to inside this, whatever you copy, you paste it here. Control Shift F, it's formatted. You can see this is the div 1 and inside the div having a one labels, and this label is nothing but it's saying like enter email address. You can say enter name, or here you can change text form control, fine. ID is also fine. If you want to remove the ID also, you can remove it. Right now not required, you are using the theme lib. And here you can say enter name. Okay, enter name. If you go to your browsers and if you see it, the effect of the input form is like this. It's a too much big, so I want to make it little bit small. How can I do it? You can do to go to the form and here you have to write class equal to call and divide with 5, and next you go to the browsers, refresh it, you can see your form is little bit small. Okay, I hope you understood. Okay, so this is the name. If you want to make it bold, you can make it bold. Whatever you want to do, you can do it. Okay fine, enter name, it's fine, it look like good also, no problem. Now what I have to do, I want like that so many things, because I want to make like this. So like this, username, email, phone number, password, confirm password and genders. Okay, those many things I want. So go to these things here and copy this and paste it. Copy this, paste it. So first I want name, second I want username, third I want email, fourth I want phone numbers. So based on your requirement you put it. Fourth I want phone numbers, phone, and next I want password, password. Next, I want confirm password. Confirm password. Okay, that much I want. And one more I want for gender, but I have not taken this one right now. Okay, so do one thing. Go to your browser, save it, and go to the browser, refresh it. You can see this form. You can see this form. Here you can enter name, email ID, phone numbers. Okay, you can see phone numbers, password, confirm password, everything is fine. Now you have to change based on your requirement, whatever he is saying. So I am going to change it like enter username. So I have to username is text. Okay, fine. Here is saying you enter username, so I have to say username. Now he is saying enter email, and I have to not put it like this. Okay, text. So text is nothing but email. Email you have to put enter email. Enter email. Next, phone number is fine. Enter phone numbers. Yeah, you can say number. You can say password, so you have to change this text to password. Here you can say enter password. Here you can change text to password. Input type password. Here you can say enter confirm password. Okay, now you go to the browsers and just refresh it. You can see something proper way. Okay, you can see something in proper way. Now if you want to make it, this one label is bold. So how you can do it? It's a very simple. Go to this place and write here B tag. So automatically it's happened. Go here, type B. 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 It's a bold tag, so through this you can make it bold through B, and this one is also B. Okay, fine. Go to this place, refresh it. You can see this type of the form. It's look like good, amazing. It's look like good, amazing. Now I have to create one, button. So for this I have to create one button. Go to down this place, and inside the form only you create one button. Inside the buttons you can write register, and here you can write like type is button or submit. And for class you can mention, for change the color, so class btn, it's a bootstrap property, and btn hyphen success. Okay, go to your browsers, you can see one button also. So one button is also available. Now I have to do work on gender. how you can see the gender. So for this you have to take one radio button. So go to this place, radio, radio or checkbox, click on this. Here you can see radio or check buttons. So if you want this one, you can take this one, but I want radio button. So go down, you can see here, this is the radio button. Okay, this is the radio button. So I want two radio button, so I will take two radio button. Okay, one or two. Go down. This is also a checkbox. Both are checkable. And this is also a radio button. So I will take this one only. Okay. Two things. One or two I want. So one or two I don't want disable. So I will take this. Okay. And go to your application. And above the button, go down and paste it. Control Shift F, it's formatted. Now you have created this two form, but this form is not inside the anything. So you have this form is F3. So take this and put here, and here you can close it. So write div. Okay, final. One more things you have to do, I will suggest you now. You have to take this label, take this label and put inside this. Okay, Control Shift F, and here you can write in the confirm password gender. Once you write the genders, go to your browsers and refresh it. You can see something. This is the radio button, gender 1 or 2, and this is the register button, confirm password. It's look like good. No problem. It's look like good. Okay. It's look good, no problem. Okay, then after, if you want to change something, like here you have to write male. In one place I want to show male, you can say male. Here you want to see female. Okay, male or female. So if you go to this place, refresh it, you can see male or female. Okay. So I hope you understood like how I am designing this user registration form, and it is look like good, not bad. Okay, so this is done. Now what I have to do, I have to write some things like how can I put this data, store this data and send to the server, so server is able to receive this data and put inside the database. So these things I have to maintain now. So for this I will go one by one in top to down. Okay, once user full everything, enter everything, like he enter name Prince Kumar, he enter Prince 123, he enter email ID PK, anything he want. If he enter everything, he doing everything, once he click on the register, what I have to call. So for this you can mention here in form label, you can mention th, this is the theme leaf, colon action equal to, you have to write like that, add the rate open brackets slash register user, register user, copy this and go to your application, go to your application. Inside the application, go to the controllers, and in controller side, you can create one more endpoint, public string user register users, and open this, close it, and return here. Any page. For examples, we have a one home page. So return the home page. Okay, and make it here like at the rate post mapping. I have to do it. So post mapping, and here you have to send same thing. Okay, then it's work. I hope it's clear. Okay, so we have created, but once first time if you call the slash method, you have to send this page one object, user object. So for this you have to create one model, control shift O. So model is created, and here you can create one user object, user equal to new users, and this user is coming from these classes, and here you can add model dot add attribute, and here you can add users, and this is going to the this page. Then you have to go to the register page, and here you can write one more things, this users, and you can write th colon object equal to double quote dollar and users. If you want to specify the method, you can specify it, its method equal to post. You have to call it. This is going to the this path. This is the object coming from this object. Okay. Now you have to put your input field data to this user object. How you can do it? Through the theme leaf. So this is one of the dangerous tasks you have to do. Not now, later. Okay, before we are going to controllers, and in controllers you have to receive whatever data is sent when you call this. So for this I have to receive this, I have to use model attribute. Model attribute, and I have received the user reference, and this is a type of users. Okay, fine. Once I store it, I will do one things. I will print here s out users, and I have to create home page also. So copy this, go to the template, this template, and go to the new file and put it home.html, and you don't want to do anything, go to this register page, copy everything, come back and put inside this, and remove the everything. Okay, here you can write h1, congratulations, registration successful. Congratulations, registration successful. You want to give a style, you can give a style also, color green. Okay, fine. One more things I have missed here. One thing, XML NS equal to double quote. I have to enable the theme leaf. So go to this place, theme leaf, call this and copy this. We don't want to do anything. Copy this, come back here, put it, remove this slash, save it. And this tag also, these things you have to put inside this also. Go to this place, save it. Okay guys, I hope you understood. Go to your browser's register page, refresh it. It's running on. Okay, no problem. Go to browser, refresh it. You can see this data. Once you click on the registers, congratulations, successfully you can see. But if you go to the this one, you can see there is nothing. Everything is what? Everything is empty. Null. Everything is null. Username, everything is null. It's not going to save this data in your database. Okay, so how you can do it? How you can do this? Okay, so for this you have to write something. I will write in front of you, no problems. So for this you have to put this data, all the input field data here. Okay, so this is the field I have to put the data. So for example, this is the input. So I will write here one more things, th colon field equal to a star or whatever the name of your entity class variables. So those are also a name, so write here name only. Copy this, go to this place, this is the another input field. Here you can write username. You have a placeholder, you don't have a I think ID. Okay, fine. And here you can see this input field. So go to this input field, write here email. Okay, go to this input field, write here phone. Go to this input field and write password. Go to this input field. It's a theme leaf concept you have to do. So automatically it's integrated. See, password. And once it is done, you have to go to the gender. So this is the radio button. So you have to take both name same. So I have taken name as a gender, and this is also a gender. Other than that, I don't want to worry about it. So 1, 2, anything you can take, no problems. I have save it and go to the browsers. Go back again, fill some data like prince. Okay, and prince 123, prince Kumar email ID, anything you can take, anything mail, register it. It's saying no, it's wrong. So pk एट द रेट gmail.com. Register it. You can go to your console. You can see still you are not able to see the data. What is the problems now? So for this, it is not a problem. Stop your server. Okay. Stop your server. Stop everything. And save everything. And one more time. Update your Maven. Update your Maven. Refresh your project. Okay, and now we try to run this. Spring Boot applications. Now you have to enter Prince Kumar, Prince, email ID, phone numbers, password is 123, confirm password is also 123, mail and register. If you go to here, you can see the data. This is the name, Prince, user ID, everything. Gender is like option 1, it's coming. So gender is coming option 1. So this is the bad, you have to write male or female here inside the gender. Okay, so this is the value you have to change. So go to your register page, and in register page you can see, go down here, he given the value option 1 and option 2. So option 2 you have to put it female, 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 and here you can to put it male. Now it's fine, and if it is done, then go to your controllers once again and call the service method and save your data in database. So save your data in database, how you can do it? So go to your controller first, man, and all this, and here you are printing right now data, you don't print it. Yeah, if you want to print, print also, no, fine. And auto wire the service here inside the controllers. So right here, private user service, user service, service, and just auto add it. Auto add it. You got it, object of service, automatically. Once you got the object of service, come here and call it service dot service, having a one method register users, and pass your users. You don't want to worry about, it's automatically going to store in your database. If you go to your database, you can see, if you refresh it, write down two tables is there. If you refresh it, you can see three tables, user register tables. If you open it, so inside there is no record right now, all are the empty, you can see. But now your application is running on. Go to your browsers, refresh your application, refresh your application, enter the name, fill the form, email ID, password is 123, confirm password is 123, tick mail, click on register. Registration successfully. Go to your database. Right now no record. Just refresh this one. You can see one record is coming, and this record is nothing but your record only. Okay. So this is the name, this is the confirm password, this is the email ID, this is the gender, this is the name, this is the password, this is the phone numbers. So registration is successfully done. One more record I want to put. Okay, so user ID is primary key. If you put more than one times, it's given you exception. So go to this place. Again, tick same things and try to register it and go to database. Refresh it, you can see there is no record. Even its registration is successful, but there is no record because it's not going to store your primary key. So you have to handle it. How can I do it? So you have to do two things. Okay, how can I handle it? So it say ki there is a duplicate or something else. Okay, go to this place, try to register, it's saying successfully, but go here and refresh it, there is no record. So I have to handle it. And one more thing I have to handle, if user ID and password, for example, this password and this password both are same, then only I have to put this data in database. Otherwise I have to say no, it's required, you have to enter it this data. So this logic I'm going to retain here. Okay, so here I am going to write like before going to insert the data in database, I will check first if password, no, user or password, user dot get password dot equals of user dot get c password, if both are equals, okay just stop sometime here. Okay, if both are equals, user ID and password both are equals. Okay, and one more things I have to handle, try and catch also. Okay, if exception is happen, then you have to go some other place. Okay, so user ID and password is right. Okay, and this user ID is available in database, so I will write one try and catch. And it's going to be the exception class, exception e. Okay, fine. So I have to write this logic when if everything is fine. It's fine. Okay, if user ID password is good, everything is good, it's going to the this and it's insert the data in database. Okay, if it is not happen. Okay, and one more things I have to, 1 minute I will come back. Okay, so one more things I have to think about it, like what I have to do. One more things I will think, yeah, user ID password is good. Okay, service dot get register users, it's also happen. If exception is occurred, it's coming to the this part. If exception is not occurred, I have to return the value in try block only. Otherwise, no, It's not a good way to return. Yeah, you can write return here also. Return these things to the home page. Okay, and return here also. You return here also error page. ERROR. Any problems? Yeah, problem is theirs. So I have to take one string. I have to take one string. A string RESU. Result equal to null. Okay, right now null. Here you can store here result. Result equal to home or result equal to error, and finally you can return here. Result. Okay, so it's check first either the password is correct. Okay, if exception is not come, then it's put these things and import inside the data in database. If problem is happen, for inserting the data in database, then it goes to the this place and saying error page. Okay, one more things. If this one is not happen, if this is not gone, then directly you have to pass here what error page only. So put it here error. Error only. Okay. And if it is error, okay, fine, no problems. Okay, so go to templates and create one more page, and this is the error page. Here you can paste your data dot html, create this, go to the any registration form, yeah, any home page, take this, copy this, come back, error.html, put here. Put here all the data and just say change the color, say red, and not congratulation, sorry, registration failed, please enter unique user ID UNIK unique user ID and same password and confirm password. It's one of the technique to say that. Okay guys, so it's happened. Now I'm going to run our applications. Now it's work whatever I expected. Run these applications and go to the controllers. You can see data is coming. It's saying like okay users, it's check both are same, then going inside this, otherwise saying this one, and it's result the error page. Okay, fine. Our application is running on. Go to the browsers, refresh it. You can see this one. Enter username, anything like Deepak. Deepak. Username is Deepak. Email is something else. Phone number is something else. Password is 123. Confirm password is 123. Male or female? Female. Register. Congratulations, registration successfully. Go to the here and refresh it. You see one more records Deepak is available. Now you give something like different things, like give the user ID and password different. First 123 give the different and try to register, saying sorry registration failed, please enter unique user ID and some password. So based on that you can customize your page, your result, anything. I have created 3 pages. You can create only one page and you can do it. It's a that much simple to do it. But I hope you enjoy this video and you are able to create this form with your own. If you face any problems, any difficulties, I will help you definitely. Okay, but I am going to explain everything in front of you. One more video, card operation, in next Saturday or Sunday maybe. So this is also a very very important, so don't forget to do this. This one is ask one company. He told me to develop one registration form, develop one login forms and give to me. If you do this, I will give you offer whatever you want. So this is the target, this is the value. If you do work in IT, if you understood, okay, so this is very very important, guys. I hope you understood. And don't forget to subscribe and like my channels, okay? It's very very important if you do it. Thank you so much for watching my video. In next video I will explain definitely how to perform the CRUD operations. CRUD operation in the sense how to fetch the data from database, display on the browsers, how to delete, how to update, how to store the data in database, each and everything I'm going to discuss. Okay, so I hope you understood everything. Thank you so much for watching my video. Bye.